The magic rock candy is one of the most powerful items in Stardew Valley, and in this video you will learn exactly what it does, how to get it, and how to use it. Foods have been an essential part of the game from the very beginning. They restore your health, your energy, and they give you buffs that make you more powerful. The magic rock candy was only added in the 1.4 version of the game, and it is the perfect food for mining. It gives you +2 mining, +5 luck, +1 speed, +5 defense, and +5 attack. Just to illustrate how powerful this item is, let me tell you that before it existed, the best item for luck was the lucky lunch, and that gave you +3 luck. And the way you got it was you learned the recipe from the TV in year 2, and you needed sea cucumbers and blue jazzes. And I, for example, used to store all those items in my fridge all the time just to be able to craft it. And I sometimes used the greenhouse to grow blue jazzes so I can craft them even if they weren't in season and I didn't have any more left. So it was a lot of trouble to craft it and to even just to learn a recipe. And that item only gave you +3 luck. And this, the magic rock candy, gives you +5 luck and all the other things that it gives you. And the same thing is true with attack and defense. The most powerful attack and defense items also never had +5 defense or +5 attacks. And even the ones that did have +3, they usually only had that one perk and not all the other things, like mining and speed. So it is an amazingly powerful item compared to what we used to have in the older versions of Stardew Valley. So now that you know how powerful it is, you must think that it must be really hard to get it, because obviously it has to be. And it is. First of all, I talked about how I used to craft lucky lunches. Now you can't craft the magic rock candy in your kitchen. There are only 3 ways to get it, and all of them are pretty difficult and grindy. First way to get it is the one I already mentioned in my other video, the one about mining iridium, is the desert trader. You can buy the magic rock candy from the desert trader. It's very expensive. It costs 3 prismatic shards, which are rare, and you could sell each of them for 2000 gold. It is only stored on Thursdays and only 1 every week. You can also get the magic rock candy as a reward from the museum. You need to donate 90 items to the museum to get it. Donating items to the museum also became easier in 1.4, because other than the wormholes and the omnigeodes, now you can also use treasure troves and the dinosaur levels in school caverns and the quarry mines to get the other artifacts. You can get it, and completing the museum would probably be something that you would do anyway, but you can only get 1 ever, and you need to grind out all the things that you will need to donate to the museum to do it. The third way of getting it is from the haunted skulls in the quarry mine. It is a rare drop, only has a 0.13% chance of dropping, and I have gone to the quarry mines every day for 14 Stardew Valley days, and I've found plenty of stuff that you can see in these 2 chests, but even I couldn't find the magic rock candy, so it's pretty rare. But if you would still like to try this method, here are some tips. It is pretty easy to clear the quarry mines. It only took me 3 minutes every time. In the end of the mine, you will find a statue holding a golden scythe. Take the scythe from it, it is better than your starter scythe. And after that, you can use the statue to teleport back to the entrance, so you don't need to walk all the way back. And there is no reason to return to the mine a second time after you have cleared it once, because some haunted skulls will spawn, but very few, and it is just a better use of time to return the next day. So overall, I think that out of the 3 methods, buying it from the desert trader, although expensive, is still the most practical option for most players. And now, here are some tips on how to use the magic rock candy. Considering how expensive this item is, I would only use it in Skull Cavern, because that's where the most valuable ores and the most dangerous monsters are. Also, because it is so precious, you will probably only have one every time you go to Skull Cavern. So, should you eat it at the beginning or in the middle of your mining trip? I got this question from a person on Reddit, so I tested it. I did 3 runs, both ways. First, I ate the candy at the very beginning, then I ate it about 7 minutes in. I didn't take any stairs with me and I used medium-sized bombs. It's a small sample size, but in my experience, it seems to be better to eat the magic rock candy whenever you start mining. In those runs, on average I got 311 iridium ores, 5 prismatic shards, and when I sold my items, 66,000 gold. When I ate the magic rock candy 7 minutes in, I got on average 275 ores, 2 prismatic shards, and 53,000 gold. That was all about the magic rock candy, the most powerful food in the game. See you next time.